My name is Tom Clark, and I'm the new regional coordinator of catechesis for the South Region. And I'm delighted to have the honor of introducing Bishop Gerard Battersby. Bishop Battersby was ordained an auxiliary bishop on January 25th, 2017, and serves as the regional moderator of the South Region. Bishop Battersby also serves as the chair of the New Evangelization Council and will continue in the footsteps of Archbishop Burns to lead our efforts to unleash the gospel in Southeast Michigan. Please help me welcome Bishop Gerard Battersby.
The Archbishop says, "I'm not going to Guam." From your lips to God's ears. I'd like to share with you what I have adopted as my Unleash the Gospel prayer. It was taught to me, so it's not my genius, but it touched my heart. I hope it'll touch yours as well. We're going to say it three times together in honor of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus, come with your life. Your resurrection, into every dead part of my being. Come, Lord Jesus, with your life, your resurrection, into every dead part of my being. Come, Lord Jesus, with your life, your resurrection, into every dead part of my being. You see, it's about the resurrection, as the Archbishop said. And by the way, Archbishop, we're grateful that you say yes every morning. It's about the resurrection, and it's about entering into that mystery, which we do most especially in the Eucharist and all the sacraments, which we do, my brothers and sisters, because this is Jesus' work among the Archdiocese of Detroit. It is for you and I to enter into, to own, and become one with him in his Father's desire that all of us might become one in Christ. I'm so pleased to be with you all today, and I pray that today will be just another spark which ignites the kindling of your hearts, which ignites it into an evangelical blaze, a fervor which reaches to your neighbor. The Archbishop's pastoral letter, Unleash the Gospel, has helped me, and I hope you, understand in a new way Jesus' words given to us in the Gospel. I have come to set the earth on fire. How I wish it were already blazing. Can you hear the urgency in Jesus' voice? Amen. Can you feel the longing and ache these words express so plaintively, expressing the deepest desire of his heart? This is his prayer, not from some distant time. It's his prayer for you and me. It's his prayer for us today. It's for Detroit. Amidst hurricanes and social unrest, amidst all the cares which vex and beset us, Jesus has come to set our hearts on fire, and he aches for that blaze to be kindled anew. I have to tell you that this ache is also in the heart of the Archbishop. It's what ultimately engendered his pastoral letter. It's what motivated his prophetic utterance of the vision of the dry bones, his convoking of Synod 16, his calling together the entire archdiocese to listen to the Holy Spirit together. This ache is what underlies our coming together today, summoned as we are by the Holy Spirit to unleash the power of the resurrection, to unleash the gospel in the Archdiocese of Detroit. As the Archbishop has said, this isn't another program from Central Services. It's a charter of the heart. It's the very reason we exist as an archdiocese. Paul reminds us that we exist to know nothing but Christ and Him crucified. Unleash the Gospel invites the entire archdiocese to set out anew, to once again bring Christ in from the peripheries of our families, of our family lives, of our own lives, of our parishes, of all our ecclesial institutions, to assume His rightful place as the living and life-giving center, the central focus of all our efforts, our reason for being, the purpose of our personal and ecclesial lives, because He is the food and the joy of our souls. To do just as the Archbishop exhorts in his pastoral letter, when he says, for everyone in the Archdiocese, every man, woman, and child, it entails making one's relationship with Jesus and alignment with His will the central guiding principle of every aspect of our lives. Jesus, my brothers and sisters, is the focus of all our efforts. It's to Him that we pledge ourselves anew. It is for and on behalf of Him that we accept His commission anew, to go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. The Archbishop has declared the presence of a new spirit, a refocused goal, a foot in our lives, in our families, and in our parishes, and in all our institutions. We don't have to wait for this to happen. It has happened. And we must, at every level of our archdiocese, as every good surfer does, catch the wave. To this end, the Archbishop has instituted and established a new evangelization council. The council is made up of the Archbishop and 13 priests, deacons, and lay members who will be tasked by the Archbishop with the goal of implementing the proposition and action steps contained in his letter. The new Evangelization Council, as this council will be called, will provide ongoing counsel to the Archbishop in terms of additions or changes needed in the action steps in order to accomplish the propositions. The new Evangelization Council will be developing resources for measuring the success of the action steps. It will assist the Archbishop with ongoing support regarding the overall effects of evangelization for the entire archdiocese. It is, I think, worth remembering that Synod 16 was and is an intensely collaborative work which engaged and engages the hearts of the entire church. This pastoral letter is uniquely representative of each one of us. It's a representative of the Archbishop's heart, of yours and mine. And it is, my brothers and sisters, ours to embrace. It's ours to own. It's ours to implement. And that is what the Archbishop charges the entire Archbishop with. This is your document. This is your charter. This is your cause to take up and go forth into that future that Christ has in store for each of us. In addition, in the Curia, there will be a companion group set up that will be known as the Action Steps Coordinating Group or something along those lines. It will be charged with implementing the action steps and translating the theoretical to the practical. My brothers and sisters, this is an exciting time to be in the Archdiocese. It's an exciting time because we place our trust in Christ, because it's to him we turn, and he provides for his children. It's with confidence that we move forward, because we know he is risen, because we know he lives and moves and has his dwelling among us, that he is risen truly. And we place our confidence in that, and we work out of the power of the resurrection, the power of the resurrection to change hearts, to reinvigorate dry wood, to give us anew that call which has been ours since our baptism. It's an exciting time, my brothers and sisters, and it's a time that is not for any particular person, but for all of us. You know, sometimes we ask ourselves, what can I do about the lack of faith around me? What can I do about the lack of faith in my pastor? What can I do about the lack of faith in my coworkers? And the answer is simply this: be converted yourselves. Allow the Holy Spirit to catch you on fire. He'll take care of the rest. God bless you. Amen.